When Rob Campbell was sacked from senior public service roles this week, there was an allegation he made that we wanted to pick up on. Campbell asserted that his sacking wasn't to do with his LinkedIn post, but was actually because the government is calling on Māori equity and co-governance approaches in the health system. Waipareira Trust Chief Executive and President of Te Pāti Māori, John Tamihere, is with us this morning. Kia ora.
Kia ora.
Was he right?
Yeah, well, absolutely. With the new Prime Minister and a new clean broom coming in, not only was there a bonfire, there is a handbrake, and it looks like it could even be in a reverse gear. Co-governance is something that is nothing to be feared. The Pāti Māori goes further and says quite clearly we own the water, and there's no evidence to suggest that that claim is wrong. So co-governance could be seen as just another confiscation. But just pretend we're working with co-governance. The question I've always asked of others is, well, what does that take from others? Governance is not ownership. Governance is stewardship and custodianship and the like. And probably we work a lot better than what we've got now.
Okay. Specifically in the healthcare system, which is what Rob Campbell was referencing this week, what evidence is there that the government is backing down from commitments around Māori health equity or co-governance within the healthcare system?
Yes, well, firstly, it's an election year. And so firstly, you've got to put out your messaging. That's been done politically. What will occur and does occur with us in terms of any change where Māori are given greater rights to self-manage, and that should be the way, but it's resisted constantly, particularly in the bureaucracy. And so we've got handbrakes going on.
But in the health system? Instead.
Yeah, well, you get into arguments over, for example, problem gambling funding. Problem gambling funding has never gone to Māori. Okay. Yet we've got major problems there, and we are the ones that can get our value-driven system into those people that are falling foul. And I'm just using problem gambling as one example. They're multiple from Plunkett across the line. Handbrakes are going on the transfer of resources to Māori by Māori for Māori.
What about the Māori Health Authority? Rob Campbell said the government hasn't resourced Te Aka Whai Order sufficiently.
Well. We would always probably back that, but on dollar values alone, if you look at what the transfers were voted in the last budget, it is a very Spartan type of a budget. But you know what? We can do a lot with very little. We vaccinated over 1.2 million Kiwis in the vaccination campaign on a very, very small budget. So we can do things quite efficiently in the communities.
Okay, I want to go to a comment from Health Minister Aisha Verrill, who says the government created Te Aka Whai Order because of our commitment to Māori participation at the highest level of health decision making. So she rejects Rob Campbell's assertion that the government is backing away from Māori equity measures in the health system. I just want to know, is there any evidence from what he said? Is there any evidence at the moment, hard evidence, that the government is backing away from any form of co-governance?
Well, this only occurred 7 days ago. Okay, so if you're asking me to get evidence as a trained lawyer relevant to giving you substance...
That's what I'm asking for, JT.
In 7 days, yeah. I can't discern that.
Yeah.
Right, so you'd have to come back to me.
Was he the right person for that job?
Well, look, here's the thing. We had, you have to understand his background, okay, and he was a lefty that then sort of had this epiphany and then become right of Genghis Khan.
Sounds like you.
So, yeah, well, we all have them. if you stop learning, there's something wrong with you. But he atoned for his wrongdoing and going down the wrong track. And in atoning for that, he started to come out quite largely. His ability, though, to unpick government budgets, his ability to cut right to the chase in regard to where blockages are, was a very important part of leadership that's been lost in the transition process. So he's a change manager, and you need change leadership and governance.
These big questions around co-governance are likely to be present for all of this year and probably for years to come, but particularly leading up to October. What do you say to people when it comes to the original Three Waters model that would give Māori a different level of representation to non-Māori on those entities that manage water assets? What do you say to people who say that's not democratic?
Well, the truth of it is, go to the heart of the matter, which is, what is the ownership model for the water? Who owns it? There's only one piece of law on this land today that allows the Crown to allocate it, not to allocate ownership, but to allocate use.
Do you accept that it isn't strictly one person, one vote?
Absolutely. But you know, when you're talking property rights and you're talking the rule of law, often that is not the case. You don't you look at the rule of law. You don't look at overriding the rights of Māori solely because you have a majority. That's the argument that's been put to us. We're the majority, we're going to make the rules, and we're going to override property rights. You can't do that.
Has the government made an argument in favour of co-governance?
No, they've been very poor. This government's been very poor at its communication approaches. I think we're all aware of that. It has some good ideas, but it just doesn't know how to market them or sell them.
Census this week. The last census was a bit of a disaster. It was revealed afterwards Māori had been undercounted in New Zealand by 50,000 people going back to 2013. Will this census be different?
Well, we don't know that. That's a guess, 50,000, but because it is.
Yeah, it's an estimate.
Yeah, yeah, well, it's a guess. So
I think it's informed. I don't think they just plucked that number out of the air.
Well, it's a percentage taken, and who determines the percentage? So I didn't want to go around...
Statisticians and
statisticians. Yeah, I didn't want to go around the mulberry bush with you, but it's wrong. So the problem we've got now is they don't learn from their mistakes. And this is very well-paid bureaucrats and statistics and so on and so forth. They're going to have to start to engage with our community leadership in all our communities up and down the country. And it's those people that have a trusting relationship with our communities that have served them with health, welfare, education or justice and not regulated them. You know, our people are there not to be punished. There is a solution waiting to happen, as we say. So problem with the census is it hasn't engaged the Māori community and I don't think it will be successful as a consequence. And I have put this to the powers that be, but we just sit on the sideline and have to fix up the pieces after.
So what will be the consequence of that if the census proves to not engage Māori?
Well, there's a significant undercount. Furthermore, one third of Māori move addresses every election. So our people, because we're not in fixed homes and in rental stocks all over the place, in transition, trying to identify a highly mobile population, let alone plan for it, makes it very difficult.
So what will be the net result?
And significant undercounts all over the shop.
Okay. All right. Well, thank you very much for your time. We appreciate it. John Tamihere.